Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today we're gonna talk about how to migrate from Shopify to WooCommerce. One of the main reasons users decide to move from Shopify to WooCommerce is that the latter is built on top of open source software. It uses WordPress, enabling you to create any website you want on any hosting platform of your choice. Unlike Shopify, WooCommerce doesn't charge you to unlock features. You also won't need to pay any processing fees to sell products. In this video, we'll discuss what you need to know to migrate Shopify to WooCommerce. We'll walk you through the preparations and guide you step by step as you move your store. Of course, before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's back up your Shopify store. One of the downsides of using Shopify is that the platform doesn't offer backup functionality. It allows you to export product data in CSV format, which will come in handy during the migration process. However, you can't back up the rest of your store's details and design using the platform's built-in functions. If you want access to real backup functionality, you'll need to turn to the Shopify App Store. Here, you'll find tools that add basic backup functionality to Shopify, such as rewind backups. It's important to note that even with apps like this, you might not be able to create complete copies of your Shopify store. You also can't use Shopify backup apps to migrate your shop. Migrating from Shopify to WooCommerce is a theoretically risk-free process for your existing store. You won't lose any of your store's data, but it's still a good idea to back up any site's data in case of issues. If you're already committed to using WordPress and WooCommerce, you'll need a web hosting provider tailored to your CMS. Kinsta is one of such hosts with specific solutions for WooCommerce stores. Thanks to it, you'll get access to great features, some of which are optimization for high traffic websites, high performance and HTTP 3 enabled CDN, enterprise grade firewall and DDoS protection, automatic daily backups, around the clock support and malware removal, staging functionality with selective push functionality, and more. Check out our WooCommerce hosting page for more info in the description below. Now that you have a web host in place, it's time to start moving your store from Shopify to WooCommerce. That process involves migrating all of your store's products and recreating its layout and design in WooCommerce. However, before we can get to that, we need to set up WordPress. WordPress offers several installation methods depending on which type of web host you're using. For example, managed WordPress hosts often set up the CMS automatically for you when you create a new website. If your web host doesn't offer automatic, you can also download and set up WordPress manually, which is more straightforward than it might sound. The software is available for download at wordpress.org. It also comes with a famous 5-minute installer that walks you through the entire process once you upload the files to your server. Once you install WordPress, you'll gain access to the dashboard. From here, you can have complete control over your website's settings, layout, and the content that you publish. Since you want to move to an online store, you'll first need to install WooCommerce. To do so, go to Plugins, then Add New, and type WooCommerce in the search bar at the top of the screen. WooCommerce should come up as one of the first results that you see. Click on the Install Now button next to the WooCommerce option. Then wait for WordPress to download and install the plugin. This process will happen in the background, so don't leave the page until the Activate button appears next to WooCommerce. Once it does, click on it. That's it. Now, WooCommerce is up and ready to go. That means you can start publishing and selling products. However, you already have a full list of products at Shopify, so let's move your catalog over to WooCommerce. As we mentioned already, Shopify enables you to export your entire product catalog in CSV format. This file includes titles, slugs, tags, variants, and prices for the products you migrate. To export your Shopify product data, go to your account and navigate to Product, then All Products. This page will show a complete list of all the products in your store. It also includes options to import and export data. Select the Export button at the top of the screen, and Shopify will ask which products you want to export. Click on All Products and select the CSV for Excel, Numbers, or other spreadsheet programs option under Export As. Once you click on Export Products, Shopify will compile a CSV file, including all your product data, and send it to you via email. That email might take a while to arrive, depending on how large your inventory is. The Shopify email will include a link to download the CSV file that contains all of your product information. Save that file to your computer because you'll need it for the next step. This step is one of the most important ones. There are two ways that you can import Shopify products into WooCommerce. One method uses the built-in product importer that WooCommerce uses, and the other is through a migration service. Let's go over both approaches, starting with the manual option. WooCommerce comes with a tool that enables you to import product lists in CSV format. You downloaded your entire Shopify catalog in one neat CSV file during the previous step, making this a very simple process. The downside of this approach is that you're only importing products. All of your store's data, such as customers, order history, images, and reviews, will remain in Shopify. In essence, you're starting over using WooCommerce with your existing inventory and a blank store slate. If that's not a deal breaker, let's go ahead and import that Shopify CSV file in WooCommerce. Access the WordPress dashboard and go to Tools, then Import. Look for the WooCommerce Products CSV option and click on Run Importer. On the next page, WooCommerce will ask you to choose the file you want to import. There's also an option for updating existing products using the data from a CSV file. Leave that unchecked as we're starting with a clean inventory. Select the CSV file you downloaded during step 3 and click on Continue. The next screen includes several options for matching product data from the CSV file to WooCommerce fields. Go through that list of options and decide which data you want to import in WooCommerce and which you're comfortable leaving out. Some fields, such as SEO title and SEO description, don't have corresponding options in WooCommerce, so you can exclude those. Once you're happy with your choices, click on Run the Importer. WooCommerce will take a minute or more to import your Shopify product data. When the process is over, you'll see a success message that looks like this. If you click on View Products, WordPress will send you to the Products, then All Products tab. Here, you'll see an overview of all the items you just imported. Remember that WooCommerce won't import product images, so you must upload these manually. We also recommend checking out each item entry to ensure it's not missing any critical information. If product data is missing, you can always rerun the importer and make sure you're porting the correct fields to WooCommerce. Overall, using the manual importer is simple, but it requires some micromanagement on your end. Migrating from Shopify to WooCommerce is common. There are entire plugins and services devoted to simplifying the process. The advantage of using Shopify migration tools is that they automate the whole process and enable you to port data that you can't with a simple CSV file. Cart to Cart is one helpful tool. It enables you to connect WooCommerce with Shopify by migrating each data point from one platform to the other. Cart to Cart offers limited free migrations that enable you to move part of your Shopify inventory over to WooCommerce. However, if you want access to the tool's complete set of features, you'll need to pay. Prices vary depending on how many products you want to import and if you wish to include customer and order data and blog posts. Cart to Cart offers an estimate tool on its site. However, to give you an idea of how much the service costs, migrating a complete Shopify store with 100 products to WooCommerce would run you about $120. If you want to use Cart to Cart, go ahead and sign up for an account. Once you access your dashboard, the platform will ask you to choose both source and destination carts. The source in this case is Shopify, and WooCommerce is the destination. For the cart-to-cart importer to work, you'll need to generate a Shopify API key. Return to the Shopify dashboard and go to the app's screen. Scroll to the bottom of the page and look for the link that reads Manage Private Apps. If you haven't enabled private app development in Shopify, you'll see a screen that looks like this. Click on the Enable Private App Development button. Shopify will ask you to enable private app development. It will also warn you about sharing your API key with unknown parties. Confirm your choice, and now you'll get the option to create a private app. Creating a private app will generate the API password cart-to-cart needs to access your Shopify and export your data. Firstly, set a name for your app and enter your email. Scroll down to the permissions section and give the app access to all the permissions on the list. You'll be using the read and write option when available, or just read access if the former doesn't show up. Traditionally, you shouldn't give an app full permission. However, as long as you don't share the API key and delete the app afterward, you should be fine. Next, select the latest version of the webhook API. Click on Save to create the app and confirm your choices on the screen that will pop up. Once the app is up and running, its API password will become available on the app details screen. Copy and paste the API in the cart-to-cart migration menu and enter your store's URL alongside it. Configuring the target cart is much easier. All you have to do is enter your WordPress login details for the administrator account, and you're good to go. Enter those details and click on Choose Entities. Cart-to-Cart will take a moment to prepare the migration process. If the credentials are correct, the program will ask you which data you want to move from Shopify to WooCommerce. The service will also offer several paid extras for migration, including images, order IDs, and more. Select the options that you want and start the migration. Depending on how much data you need to export or import, the process can take a while. Afterward, Cart-to-Cart will show you a success screen and give you an option to send you to your WooCommerce store, where you'll be able to see the results. At this stage, you should already have a fully working WooCommerce store that includes all your Shopify products. However, there are still several things left to do, including updating your domain records so that they point towards your new web host. Currently, your domain is still pointing to your Shopify store. You probably don't want to register a new domain because that means you'll need to start building traffic from scratch. As such, you may lose a significant percentage of your customer base. The process for changing which site a domain points to varies depending on which service you use to manage it. If you use a domain registrar, you'll need to update your records there. That process differs from registrar to registrar. If you registered a domain directly through Shopify, you'd need to edit your DNS settings using the platform. Alternatively, some web hosts, such as Kinsta, enable you to update your domain records from your hosting control panel. MyKinsta, for example, makes it easy to point domains toward your website. WordPress enables you to decide your URL structure, including for WooCommerce products. By default, WordPress URLs look something like this. That type of URL is not user-friendly. It also doesn't do you favors from a search engine optimization perspective. To change your store's URL structure, go to Settings, then Permalinks, then Product Permalinks, and select the option that you prefer. In most cases, we recommend that you use the standard structure. With it, a WooCommerce product URL will look like this. This type of URL gives visitors information about what product they're seeing, forcing you to use descriptive slugs. Once you select a permalink structure, save the changes to your WordPress website. It's important to note that you need to choose a permalink structure when starting your WooCommerce store. Changing link structures at a later date can impact your site's SEO and cause significant errors within your website. The earlier you set a permalink structure, the fewer headaches you'll face down the road. If you checked out any of your WooCommerce store's pages, you probably noticed that they look nothing like their Shopify equivalents. That's because you're still using one of the default WordPress themes. At this stage, you have two options for how to approach your new store's design. First, recreating the style of your Shopify store, and second, starting over with a new WooCommerce template. Both approaches are valid and they both involve looking for the perfect WooCommerce theme for your shop. On the one hand, recreating your Shopify store design can make the transition more seamless for your existing customers. On the other hand, WordPress offers significantly more customization options than Shopify. With the CMS, you get access to multiple page builder plugins that work with WooCommerce and enable you to customize your store in any way you see fit. To customize your store, you can also use the built-in block editor with a WooCommerce-friendly theme. Either approach is viable, so decide what to do with all the features that WordPress and WooCommerce offer you. Importing products into WooCommerce and customizing your store style is just the beginning. Before you can start selling products via WooCommerce, you still need to configure a variety of settings, including payment and shipping options, security settings, email notification options, product settings, and tax options. If you remember the process of configuring your Shopify store, all of those settings should sound familiar. However, WooCommerce gives you far more control over how you set up your online store. The official WooCommerce documentation includes a complete guide on how to configure its settings. Once you're done tweaking your store's configurations, we recommend checking out some WooCommerce extensions. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan and a 30-day money-back guarantee and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.